7 Big Ten regular season titles in 19 years. Back-to-back in 1994 and 95. They were champs again in 2000, en route to a Final Four finish. Then back again in 03 and 04, when Mazzanti and Wright wore the blue and white.
It's the fourth time the Lady Lions have captured the Big Ten regular season crown.
Penn State wins the Big Ten championship. Standing ovation.
I could not be prouder to represent Penn State University.
And in the Coquese Washington era, the Lady Lions now have done it again, going back-to-back as the Big Ten's best.
Bentley pull-up jumper from 18 is good. And the Penn State Lady Lions, for the second consecutive year, are the Big Ten regular season champions.
On this week's episode of Courtside with Coquese, you'll get a chance to share with us one of the most special moments of the season, clinching the Big Ten championship. We've got the newest member of our Lady Lion family here, our 2013 Big Ten championship trophy, and it's been a really exciting season. We've done a lot of special things this year, including going undefeated in the Bryce Jordan Center. So we actually were able to culminate a fantastic season with our Pink Zone game, Senior Day, and winning the Big Ten championship. In order to win a Big Ten championship, you need contributions from everybody. And certainly this year, we've had some fantastic performances from a lot of our players. Maggie Lucas has shot the ball extremely well. Alex Bentley has run the show, and our post players have held it down inside. But one player who kind of goes under the radar a little bit, but still is really an impactful player for us, is Ariel Edwards. She had a fantastic game against Michigan, and her play was key to us clinching another Big Ten title. Here's a look at number 23 going to work.
Moving it around, Edwards from the wing, pulls it home. The length and the size that she has. She never played the perimeter position until she came to Penn State. Now she gives this team a lift every night coming off of the bench.
I really like Ariel Edwards in that starting spot. As you mentioned, a very versatile player. She adds a lot defensively.
To Ariel Edwards off the glass and good.
Ariel right underneath the basket, lays it up and in.
Penn State again able to tap inside. Ariel Edwards.
Around to Edwards. Penetrates, pull up jumper from 10 is good.
Ariel Edwards, small forward, junior, Elmont, New York. I'm Ariel Edwards, and here's three things that you need to know about me. One, my favorite color is red. Two, my mom is from Panama. And three, I like to read books on my Kindle.
Here's a look at what's trending now in Lady Lion basketball. This week, Penn State claimed the lucky number 7 spot in both the AP Top 25 and USA Today Coaches Poll. They've been in the top 10 all season. Last Sunday's win in front of more than 14,000 fans earned the team a perfect 14-0 home record. The Pink Zone crowd was the fourth largest in school history, and fan support has been a driving factor in this team's success. Season ticket information for next year is available at gopsusports.com. Earlier this week, junior guard Maggie Lucas picked up her third Big Ten Player of the Week honor of the season. She's the active NCAA career leader in three-point field goal percentage, which is part of the reason she and teammate Alex Bentley were named to the Ann Myers Drysdale Award midseason watch list for Women's Basketball National Player of the Year. Bentley was named to the Nancy Lieberman Award list, which is given to the top collegiate point guard in women's Division I basketball. Winners will be announced during the Final Four weekend, April 7th through the 9th. And our last award announcement this week, Giselle Studevant was selected to the inaugural All-State WBCA Good Works Team that honors student athletes who have made outstanding contributions in volunteerism and civic involvement. Congrats to this inspiring senior who established a Penn State program to tackle bullying in schools. Penn State is the top seed in the Big Ten Women's Basketball Tournament, which kicks off in suburban Chicago on March 7th. Earning a first-round bye, the Lady Lions play at 6 p.m. on Friday, March 8th. More info is at ChicagoMarchIsOn.com. That's what's trending now. For more, check us out on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter at Penn State WBB or on Instagram at Penn State Lady Lions. Just ahead, we meet the Lady Lion office staff that keep this team running all year round and celebrate the success of the 7th annual Pink Zone at Penn State.
Courtside. Each week on Courtside with Coquese, you've had an opportunity to meet the people behind the scenes, the team that makes our team work. You've met with operations staff, we've introduced you to our health and wellness team, our game day operations. So this week, we're gonna take a look at the women who keep Lady Lion basketball offices running year round. Our administrative support staff, Shay McMullen, Mary McCacken, and Stephanie Zonars.
My name is Mary McCacken. I am a staff assistant in the Lady Lion basketball office for Coquese, Washington. I have been with Lady Lion basketball for a little over 10 years. I do the daily business operations, the financial operations, and I keep her calendar. There's no doubt, I love my job and I love Lady Lion basketball.
Hi, I'm Stephanie Zonars, and I'm the coordinator of community outreach for Lady Lion basketball. I basically help the team to connect better to the community, both the Penn State community as well as the State College and greater community, through things like school assemblies and visits to some of the Pink Zone beneficiaries that we've done this year, as well as handling Coquise's speaking schedule and being a liaison for her. I really love working with Coquise, because I think she's a phenomenal leader. And the philosophy that she is building this program on is something that I can really identify with and buy into.
My name is Shay McMullen. I am the administrative support assistant, and I help the coaches with all the aspects of recruiting, as well as book their travel, and I also oversee the student workers. Working with Coquese has been an amazing experience. She is one of the most down-to-earth, humble people that I've ever met. I absolutely love the team. Every time the girls come in, it just brings a smile to my face. They all have their own personalities and just are such sweet natured. It is a wonderful experience working for Lady Lion Basketball. It's truly an organization that's more like a family than it is a job to come to.
We all know the Lady Lion players love Happy Valley and the Penn State campus. So let's take another look at where they like to hang out.
Hi, I'm Ariel Edwards, and we're at the Arboretum at Penn State. This is my favorite spot on campus. This is my favorite place because of all the beautiful plants, the trees, and the nature. A lot of people come here, spend time with their families. I actually think I saw a Girl Scout troop here, so it's a field trip. Some people even get married here. Even as a kid, I always loved water, and there's a park by my house that has a beautiful fountain. It's not as nice as this one, but this is a great place to sit around and read a book, and that's what some people are doing. And it looks really nice at night. Thanks for joining me on my tour of the Arboretum.
Hey, I'm Marissa Wolf, and one of my favorite spots on campus is right here by the Hintz Family Alumni Center Pond. I really like this place because it reminds me of home, really, with all the trees and the animals around. And just kind of sitting by the water. It's like sitting by the river. Now you know my favorite spot on campus here. Thanks for coming.
Hey everybody, I'm Candace Agee, and I'd like to show you a couple of my favorite places here on campus. Starting with the Lion Shrine. The very famous place. Everybody has to come here to take their picture. I know it's the first place I came when I got on campus on my official visit. Everybody likes to come and get their picture taken. Like these two. Come on. And I'm gonna take it. One, two, three. Nice. Now I want to show you guys my other favorite place, right over here. This is Rec Hall. Some people don't know this, but this was the original home of the Lady Lions before we moved over to the Bryce Jordan Center. Tons of great basketball players have blessed this court, and now it just happens to be the home of the Nittany Lion volleyball players. I mean, look at it. 5-time national champions. Whew. Actually, I think they're about to start practice right now. Let's go see how they look. You know, Lady Lions come out and support all the time. They come to watch us, we come to watch them, you know. We got that whole one team, one love going on, you know. Little did you know, I was a 2-sport phenom back at Silverado, and I did mess with volleyball. I bet I still got a mean serve, too. Don't tell my coach, though. Ooh, that's how you do it. So there it is, Rec Hall, one of my favorite places on campus. I come here to do a little studying during the school year. They have a little space for all of the student athletes to stay on top of their game mentally and physically. Speaking of studying, I got class. See you at the games.
The Lady Lions head to Chicago next week to compete for the program's 10th Big Ten title. More info is available at ChicagoMarchesOn.com. And just ahead, Penn State continues the fight against breast cancer.
Tip, and they will stop the action, and then they'll do the real one, and we'll get things underway. They head to the locker room, down by 14.
We'd like to honor and celebrate the breast cancer survivors in attendance at today's wonderful Pennsylvania Pink Zone game. Please give a warm welcome to these brave and strong individual survivors. Representing their years of survivorship. We tallied those numbers, ladies and gentlemen, and standing here on center court this afternoon, we have 3,167 years of survivorship.
Score 68-57, and the Penn State Lady Lions, for the second consecutive year, are the Big Ten regular season champions. Mia Nixon, senior, power forward.
Your last chance to get an authentic Alex Bentley jersey.
Marissa Wolf. She has done an unbelievable job off the basketball court as well as on the basketball court. Giselle Studer. 775 for Nikki Green's jersey.
Today, we brought a bus with 98 people, survivors and friends from the Lehigh Valley. I didn't realize until I went on their website how many things the girls do throughout the year. When I saw how involved they were with the cancer support communities, Hershey Medical Center, I can't say enough about them. They're like really involved student athletes, just good people.
We rode a Fullington bus over, and everybody just seems to get along and share their story, and it's great to hear other survivors.
It is just an awesome feeling of all the support that you have all around you. Every year when we're down on the floor, I always have my personal meltdown. just knowing that everybody around me has also had breast cancer, and everybody in the stands are there to support us. Without our support, the breast cancer survivors can't get there.
Being on that floor with all of them, it just touched my heart.
As a survivor, to be on the basketball court and to look up, you see the lion in pink, you see the girls in pink, and then you look up and see all the support that is in the stands for you, it's amazing.
You don't think you can have joy with breast cancer, but the joy that just radiates from everybody is a wonderful experience.
Penn State locks up the Big Ten regular season title on Senior Day when Courtside returns.
This senior day was really special for us because this group of seniors, Alex Bentley, Giselle Studevant, Marissa Wolf, Nikki Green, and Mia Nixon, have meant so much to this program, and they've done so much to elevate Lady Lion basketball back to championship form. Senior day is always a really emotional day. And as coach, you never quite know what you're gonna get from your players on senior day. Are they gonna be too psyched up to play? Are they gonna be too filled with emotion to really execute the game plan? It was a great day for the fans to honor and celebrate them. And the chance to play for a Big Ten title on the same day really made Senior Day one to remember.
Bentley penetrates, takes it down the lane, kicks it across to Lucas. Wide open three for Lucas. That one is good. Far corner to Elmblad, and she has the ball go right through her hand.
Right now, Marissa Wolf had not played in a game since their tournament game against LSU last year, but a great gesture from her head coach there.
Down low to Nixon. Nixon on Jordan, off the glass and good.
Oh, the quick hands. Alex Bentley somehow finds Maggie Lucas all alone. How did Bentley find her? Such a big part of Penn State's game. They force over 20 turnovers per game.
Against Arnold, kicks it back to Lucas. Deep three for Maggie is good. Lucas with 15 points, and that one was from pretty far out. Studevant, two-pointer from the baseline, up and good. Giselle Studevant gets a bucket in her final game here at the Bryce Jordan Center.
Penn State shot the ball really well in the first half, also did a really good job defensively, but with that quick start, the Lady Lions were able to build that lead up.
Penn State in search of its 20th straight home win, third longest such streak in the nation. Second half coming up.
Pull-up jumper in the paint, no good. Batting in the rebound around and pulling it down is Nixon. Here's Taylor. Now a great pass down low to Nikki Green, who just sealed Rachel Sheffer off.
The spin move, Mia Nixon under control.
Shot clock at three. Offensive foul, Nia Jordan. Dar Taylor gets in the way.
Oh, you can hear this Lady Lion crowd, over 14,000 plus. To Ariel Edwards. What a big shot.
Jordan kicks it off to Brene Harris down the lane. Blocked out of bounds by Tori Waldner. And the pull-up jumper from 18 is good, and the bucket is good. And Penn State's gonna win it. The final score is 68-57. And the Penn State Lady Lions, for the second consecutive year, are the Big Ten regular season champions.
So three, one, two, three,
Big Ten!
just love playing here. I think, you know, from our freshman year all the way up to now, you know, the more support we've gotten, the better we've been at home. You know, the fans are great. You know, people are coming to the games, the marketing department getting people to our games and things like that. Students coming to our games. It's just amazing. Like, we just feed off of that.
You know, Riss hasn't played all year, and I think it was amazing that she got to step on the court and go out like a amazing senior, you know what I'm saying?
You know, we felt like she had earned and deserved the opportunity to get a chance to be out there and to wear her uniform one last time.
We all came in with the same thoughts of, you know, wanting to turn around the program, get it back to where it was before. And I think we all bought into it. We worked really, really hard, and you know, the pieces just kept adding, and we just kept going, kept working hard.
We're just pleased that we've been able to come in here this season, night in and night out, and give our best effort and be one with our fans, you know, be one team, and have a season like this where, you know, every night you leave a Lady Lion game this year, you leave with a smile on your face. I'm so proud of you guys. I hope you guys enjoy it. You know, you've learned how to be champions. And for the seniors, when you walked on this campus, you didn't know. You didn't know how to be champions. And we said that 4 years from now, before you leave this campus, you will know what it's like to be a champion. You will know what it's like to have an impact. You will know what it's like to change a culture. And you've done that. You guys have laid the foundation for what champions look like, be like, act like. We love you, Kyle!
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you. I love y'all too. 1, 2, 3.
Champions!
Talia East blocks the shot of Kiana Kellogg. Outlet pass to Edwards, ahead to Lucas. Lucas spins down the lane, off the glass, and good. It's a one-point game. Gann throws it right to Banham. Another turnover, and here is Banham down the floor, and a blocking foul called on Lucas. The basket is good. Nikki Green with the rebound and the putback, and it's a 10-point game. Rings, taps the top of her head. Bentley takes it right out of her hands. Throws the ball ahead and lays it up and in.
Knocking off the number 7 team and top team in the Big Ten.
And it's over.
And Penn State's defense didn't get it done tonight.
A shocker on the road. Penn State looks to rebound Sunday in the Big Ten season finale in Lincoln, Nebraska. With a win there, Penn State will secure the regular season title outright. Then it's on to the Big Ten tournament. Penn State plays Friday, March 7th at 6 p.m. More info is at ChicagoMarchIsOn.com. Full schedule, ticket information, news, and more is at GoPSUSports.com. I'm PJ Mullen. Thanks for going courtside.
This has been a production of WPSU.